I am not sure exactly where this video is going to take me, but I saw something this morning in the newspaper, and it was just a really interesting article, so bear with me because I hope this leads somewhere good, something that you can take away from this. Anyway, the title of this ad in the newspaper was "Prosecution Rests in the Trial of Two Attorneys." And this is the story about one of our local tow truck operators, owners here in this area, who about 4 years ago had been accused of soliciting sex from a 17-year-old girl. Well, I found that it was very interesting because I thought that this particular trial had seen its day, been there, done that. But evidently, the attorneys that represented him is the ones that are on trial. And it says that they are on trial because they had encouraged their client, which is the tow truck company owner, to get into what was called a civil compromise. He was accused of sexually assaulting a 17-year-old girl. It says, during the testimony on Tuesday in Yuba County Superior Court, the owner said he believed if the girl did not testify, then the district attorney would not be able to prosecute any criminal case against him. However, he said that he knew that a civil compromise with the girl wouldn't guarantee that she wouldn't decide to file charges in the future. Basically, what it comes down to here is it says that the Deputy Attorney General, I'm assuming California, Barton Bowers, because it's in my town, has a case against two attorneys, Jesse Santana and David Vasquez. They are charged with felonies in relation to an alleged illegal contract that was negotiated between the owner of the tow truck driver, then aged 42, and the girl that had accused him of sexually assaulting her while she was employed at the towing company. The agreement supposedly would prevent the girl from testifying against him in exchange for $100,000. It was not a binding contract because the owner of the tow truck company never signed it. So then I guess the deputy attorney asked the owner of the tow truck company, when negotiating this civil compromise, if he was looking for a guarantee that the girl would not testify. And of course his response was, yes, that's what I was paying for. Then it says that the owner of the testimony also touched on something that was in a 163-page transcript, a statement, that if he had asked his attorney, Mr. Vasquez, what he was supposed to do if he was faced with the problem of her filing charges, and the attorney's response to him was, we're just going to pay the bitch off. Nice. Real nice. So anyway, the defense attorney, Michael Barrett, argued that even though he may have used this type of language, this does not disclose that there was any malice in the situation. Simply discloses that he has bad manners. So one of the reasons that this whole situation kind of just hit me in the face is I have been following a woman whom I love. She's very solid. Her name is Tami Pepperman. And she has a website called ChooseYourSide.org. And Tami, if you happen to be watching, or Bo, just absolutely love your work. I can see the brilliance in it all, helping to really bring balance about between our physical life and what we're experiencing in our spiritual. And it just everything that you say is absolutely what I mean, it's me. It's just that you put it in such awesome words. And I'm actually going to use a bit of your website today and give you some props for it, because I went to your website and I'm going to use your website to share about how, if we want to know who the mysterious entities are at the top that is running this matrix, the hierarchy, you say is the hierarchy is the board of governors, then the insurance companies, and then the courts. And then under that, she says the hierarchy is attorneys, attorneys, attorneys. Isn't that just the truth? I mean, if you think about it, I was, and like the way my bangs were all flipped out there. If you think about it, I was an insurance agent. That was what my career was. Can't believe that was my career. I made so much money, but I had to get out because it was absolutely in conflict with who I am as an individual. I don't care about money. And I was too honest. You know, I was just too honest. It was all about making money. I mean, I don't care if you're buying car insurance or homeowners insurance. It doesn't matter if you're buying mutual funds or life insurance. I want you people to know that an insurance agent is sitting there and their goal is to get and convince you to buy as much insurance as possible, because it's all about the bottom dollar. And insurance agents have quotas to make. We had quotas. And if we didn't make those quotas, life was very difficult, because we had people we had to answer to. And if the office didn't make the quotas, then the manager, you know, had someone that he had to answer to. And it's just, it's all about the money. And the way it works is that you go get into a car accident, and this just happened to my daughter. You file a lawsuit for, let's say, $10,000, something simple, some lost wages for a couple of months, get your vehicle fixed. The insurance company suddenly doesn't even want to return your call to replace a baby's car seat. That's actually what happened. The baby's car seat, which is involved in the accident, and couldn't even get them to return a call. The husband had no health insurance, and so he needed to see a doctor. He was in a tremendous amount of pain. Insurance companies doesn't return a call. So, you know, I told my daughter, I said, well, just call the insurance commissioner. I mean, that's all I could really recommend. Give the insurance commissioner a call and let them know that this company is not responding. So she does that. And she still just is getting the runaround. And I mean, we're talking a week went by, and her husband was unable to work, laid up. So anyway, she decides to go get an attorney. I would have had some better recommendations, but you know, they got to learn their lessons. So she gets an attorney, and this, you know, they encouraged him to see his doctor regularly, no matter, you know, what, put the money out of pocket. If he needed to have any physical therapy or chiropractic work, just go do it. It was all good for the case, remember? I mean, it's just all good for the case. So anyway, she finally got the settlement, and it started out that the lawsuit was started out at $20,000, and then it ran out over like 6 months of the attorney racking up the bill, hourly wages for making the phone calls and staying in contact with everyone. And so, make a long story short, you know, it was this back and forth thing. I think they ran up something like $8,000 in doctor bills. And then, of course, the attorney's bill was a few thousand, $4,000 or $5,000 himself. Anyway, they ended up getting a check for $1,600, not even enough to fix their car. And I asked her, I said, how did this happen? And she's like, I don't know. She says the attorney And the chiropractor that the attorney sent my son or my husband to ended up making more money in this accident than we did. So something is terribly wrong. They didn't even get enough money to pay off their doctor bills. So consequently, he was out of work, ran up the doctor bills. And so, you know, even though the chiropractor may have gotten his money and the attorney got his money, emergency room didn't get any money. Their vehicle's still sitting. It's been sitting for 8 months because they can't even get it fixed. And they were rear-ended. Oh, good insurance, don't worry about it. Well, the only ones that made a profit out of this whole thing was the attorneys and the insurance companies. So anyway, I just want to get back to what I was going to say. This is from Tammy Pepperman's website, chooseyourside.org. The Broadcasting Board of Governors owns the global civil media, every bit of it. The CIA branch puts on the intelligence productions, and that's their function. So what they have done, they have tricked us into giving up our estates at birth. Politicians have been commissioned state for a very long time, so they're actually a commissioned state themselves, commissioned out of the treasury. The first commission was from the absolute treasury by the House of Lords, which commissions Congress to protect humanity. Congress accepted this business schematic, and they entered into the Confederacy in 1781 with the Articles of the Confederacy, which would be the Patriots recognized that the Declaration of Independence means a pendant or a pending state. So think about that. Independence. Yes, you are. You are independence, my people. So we are all in a pending state. And so they're pooling your insurance. That would be on us through our life, our lives. Make a claim against our life insurance, claiming that you are dead civilly. Then they hold your estate, posing as the good guy, until one of the heirs, you, come along and claim it. The first taxing agency the banks created by the 1789 Judiciary Act, there have been no lawful judges since this act. They were supposed to be collecting taxes from corporations, which was the core process. Then later they perverted that again and called it the IRS. The original courts, the 1789 Judiciary Act, established a banking routing system where everything that you do goes through it. These judges sit on a bench, and bench etymology is nothing more than a bank. So when you go to a judge for justice, you are going to be administered to offset congressional debt, not for any lawful judgment, but rather to help them get rid of the debt. They are basically nothing more than attorneys in black dresses, and I've often called them the priests in black robes, where you go to your to make a confession, and then the judge gives you penance in the form of dollar bill signs. That's my comment right there. Congress basically is trafficking human beings and is facilitating genocide on many levels. Attorneys pit us against each other, and they profit from it. Of course, all citizens have been indoctrinated, and by fourth-generation warfare, fourth generation, instilling patriotism and winning hearts and minds through the education system to condition us not to see this and stand up and claim our own estates and be living, not civilly dead, and not let them administer our state. Patriotism is calling the state your father. And that comes from the work pater or genitive patros, father. But in the Bible, Jesus was very clear that we are not to call anyone or anything father. Patriots, veterans, and constitutionalists, listen up. If you doubt anything that's being said here, go to the 1832 Nullification Proclamation Act by Andrew Jackson. He determined that it was contempt of court to argue statute or legislation. People are still demanding their rights, and it was all over in 1832. Nor shall any copy of the record be permitted or allowed for that purpose, and that any purpose attempting to take such appeal shall be punished for a contempt of court. They have not allowed true evidence on the record since then. We changed that with lawful papers and then evidenced many things, including the United States of America incorporating that is committing genocide against humans, and it is on the record. And I absolutely agree with her wholeheartedly because I've seen all of this for myself, and that is what happened. Some people want to argue common law, which is basically communism. You're asking for a judge to decide by precedent or case law or predetermined similar judgment. Well, she says, no thanks, and I agree. So it's humans versus the psychopaths. I've talked about that too. They have sold us many concepts. I'm the concept person for sure. We are out of our natural state of being, the ultimate depopulation schematic. Tell a vision. They're telling you a vision. They're giving you the vision. Programming and music industry are showing psychopaths on the screen and marketing it as beautiful, influencing small minds and adults alike, subliminally and consciously for some. Humans help each other evolve and become better, but this process has become impeded by the legal process and the fourth generation warfare by the Cro-Magnon man, which are the true psychopaths. They're de-evolved spirits. Human beings are evolved species from the Neanderthal lines who have developed a fully functioning frontal lobe of the brain, who have the empathy and love for each other and hold humanity in higher power and wealth. We have been conditioned to replace human feelings and things. Would you like to say hello? This is my mater. Say hi, mater. He says no. I think somebody is getting hungry and I'm not ready to feed him. When he's hungry, he gets pretty rowdy. So, anyway, say hi, Mater. Yeah, he says, I'm hungry. Feed me, Mama.
You're listening to The Public Law with Bo and Tami right here on These Changing Times Radio, thesechangingtimesradio.ning.com. We are a listener-supported radio station. And if you'd like to donate, please visit us at our site and click on our support pages, as every little bit helps. You were just listening to Sheena Living Waters, and I love her to pieces. This was absolutely beautiful, and hopefully soon we'll get her on the air live. We're talking about it behind the scenes, and hopefully we'll be facilitating that soon. And it's just a wonderful addition to our family here at These Changing Times. At thesechangingtimesradio.ning.com. Now, we had some concerning happenings today at WTHR.com. Two IMPD officers dead following Indianapolis SWAT situation. Okay, now, corporate counsel has decided to kill two officers and call it a murder-suicide. If you go to WTHR.com, you will find many, many, many friends and family on there, WTHR.com, sorry, and again, it's on my Facebook wall as well and all over, as well as Father Strife. You'll find that many, many officers and family members, loved ones of these two officers are also commenting, and this is not characteristic of either one of them, especially the male who they're vilifying and attempting to blame for this murder-suicide. But we all know it's corporate counsel, and this is fourth-generation warfare. It talks about how they had pressure going on, and the most profound aspect was, of course, Andrew Seward is down there stomping around. He's corporate counsel there in Indianapolis. And this is what he does to facilitate discharge of congressional bankruptcy as corporate counsel. Now, to all law enforcement, again, please, please, please hear us. This is not a joke. It's not funny to me. Nanette Vega says, and as for Dan and Delaney, she actually said, I was as much a criminal as my ex-husband because I protected him back then. Yes, I did, because he would have killed me. I said, when you are told this protective order will help, but not from long distances. I was 23 years old with my babies, and the only help I really had was from Sergeant Joe Moore and my fellow officers.
Maybe we should read the story first.
Okay.
Before we get into the comments, because, yeah, the comments section, I meant to tell you, Tammy, that we need to get I'll go ahead and just do it now, get a screenshot of what's there, because who knows how long your comments will remain sometimes, right?
Absolutely. So I'll let you read it, because...
Okay. Fine. WTHR Indiana News Leader. IMPD officer fatally shot by ex-husband and murder-suicide. So, when Tammy's, you know, scoured through the information here and knows how this stuff works, so that is why she is suspecting the conclusion that she started off with. Now, okay, so grief counselors will be on hand today for IMPD officers dealing with the loss of two officers who were killed in an apparent murder-suicide. The IMPD SWAT team was requested to OFC Kimberly, that's Officer Kimberly Carmack's home in the 2400 block of Irishmore Court on the west side of Indianapolis around 5:30 p.m. Thursday. So this is a little more than a day old. Okay. Police say Sergeant Ryan Anders, a narcotics officer, who had been with the IMPD for 9 years, broke into his ex-wife's home and fatally shot her. He then turned the gun on himself. Carmack was a 20-year veteran with the IMPD.
About to retire.
Yes, and so then you've got, it looks like fluff statements from the department. We want to elaborate on that anymore?
It's just irritating, and that's what it is. It's an advertisement, but the comments say... what's actually going on.
Because 20 years is like a pension number, right?
Right. That's a retirement age. And it's absolutely profound, the comments, because Lynette J. Vega, she's also an officer down there. She was. She says, I knew both Ryan and Kim and consider them good friends. There has to be much more to the story because I have seen him at his worst and he still would not hurt a fly. As for the domestic violence network in Indianapolis, it is a joke. I was also an officer, and I was beaten over and over and over again. And when I left the department and ran with my children, who I had custody of... Oh, now it's wanting to play games here. Who I had custody of, they found me and took my kids away from me. I have not seen my boys for over a year now, and they are living in the same home as my abuser. Now, any law enforcement officer, this is what's happening to the average human being every single day. Mothers and fathers, and corporate counsel only puts children with the abuser. Now, you have witnessed false allegations throughout time, and the average law enforcement officer is not the detectives or the FBI agents that are signing these police reports or these witness statements. Now, I'm living proof of the actions of Andrew Seward, as is Bo. He likes fourth generation warfare. He likes to pull the gas and pull the electric, and they like to play games in court. Now, I was being evicted last year unlawfully, and so they started by cutting the gas. Then, later on, they pulled the gas meter, and then I went into court upon a motion, not going into court, really. And when I went up in there upon motion for relief here, this judge prayed on me, and as I was walking outside of the court, outside of this courtroom that corporate counsel is maintaining, adult protection was there. Adult protection cornered me to the corner, and they said, you know what, honey? We got lots of benefits for you. Do you need help? You know, stuff just happens. Stuff just happens. We can give you money for your gas bill and your electric bills and your utility bills. Do you want us to put you up in new housing? Now, this is their function. They apply the pressure from the back end. And then, of course, washing their hands in holy water as they're crucifying me, they're offering me all of this charity, which is what chief priests and scribes do, chief priests and elders do. This is their function. Now, please, please, please look into this story of these officers that were murdered because they didn't kill themselves.
Now, let's expand on the story a little bit, because it says they were in one place. They call her the ex-wife. The other, later on, it says they were in the process of a divorce.
Right.
Okay? So, because, you know, how the attorney has to get his hands into every asset, you know, including divorce proceedings.
Right. And now especially. They've probated the whole estate.
But, so, they were married, and she had a restraining order on him, and... Let's see, those who knew Kamrick said her love for police work spilled over into the family, where she currently has a son, Dustin, on the police force as well. So.
He's in danger.
He is. And if you were listening to this, I would ask him to stop and think about what kind of law enforcement does he want to work for? Does he want to work for this commercial enterprise, or does he want to uphold the public law? Which would absolutely be adverse to this sort of thing ever happening in the first place.
Right.
With the public law in place, these things just would not occur like this very often. Because the community would step in and say, hey, this is a danger. We got to remove the danger
right. To
our community here.
Right. And if there's no danger, there's no pity. The attorneys have to polarize the wife and the husband away from each other, against each other, and make up these stories. They have to offer these things. You know, and that's what they were doing with myself and Bo last year.
And so it'd be interesting to see what the soap opera was going on at work.
Right.
Between these two, and where the conflict really escalated to this point.
The FBI?
Well... Allegedly, yeah.
But we've watched that over and over again. These federal agents only work on behalf of corporate counsel, and those federal agents are usually detectives. They're trained at Quantico. You want to be wary of your fellow officers that are not trained in what you're trained in. They're trained at Quantico. That means they're federal agents, and they work on behalf of Congress. They protect judges, and they protect attorneys. They don't protect law. They do not enforce law. They enforce policy, corporate policy.
Right, which is basically what's going on over at the Bundy Ranch.
Right, national security.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been like that forever. And now with the Bundy Ranch fiasco, here they are. They have the CIA on the ground. This is another implication of civil war, just like Syria, Israel, Palestine, Iraq, Iran, Afghanistan, Greece. All over. This is what these attorneys do. They have their own production company called the CIA. You can read about this in the Church Committee Reports, Book 4, Supplementary Detailed Staff Reports. Now, this is from the horse's mouth. Supplementary Detailed Staff Reports on Foreign and Military Intelligence. And you can find in there who assassinated JFK. You can find in there all sorts of these things, but nobody wants to read it. And if you don't want to read it, I read it for you. It's up on YouTube, Tami K32. I called it Foreign Military Intelligence, Part 1 and 2. You can find it over there on Bono's Entertainment as well.
So it says that Ryan was a soft-spoken, kind of jokester kind of guy, and they had an awful lot of friends coming from Officer Owensby that remembers Ryan Anders.
Right.
So in both of them, in the video, I believe I was watching a video on this earlier, yes. There's also a video on this page, but they were both very well liked and
loving.
And he was not, you know, they're painting him to be, anyways, a very like soft spoken, jokester kind of guy. Like maybe You know,
they did the same thing.
Officer Santa was that night. I was accosted by the FBI agent.
Right, and the FBI agents, you have to realize that they are not officers; they are agents. Under the 1929 Geneva Convention, officers are prisoners of war, just like citizens. Agents are not. Attorneys are not. Attorneys have taken an oath to the bar, to the banking industry, under the Banking Act, the Emergency Banking Act, which is 12 U.S.C. You can go find their oath at 12 United States Code, subsection 73. And it's foul, because this has got to stop now.
So the hierarchy of this has always been structured so that really the FBI and attorney are on kind of the same side of the surety spectrum, and that they weren't sureties.
Right, and they kill people if they need.
So they didn't go after each other. So that was kind of a. Like a mechanism that looks like the federal government had in their back pocket to
right.
keep things on top.
Always. And they kill law enforcement. We saw that with Potter and Evans in the Jerry and Joe Kane incident. Potter and Evans were executed by somebody who was their peer. They were on their knees. They were beat about their heads. But the Southern Poverty Law Center, full of attorneys, blames some other kind of weird-ass citizen. But it wasn't a citizen that killed those cops. I've read the autopsy report. Any law enforcement, if you want the autopsy reports, I've got them. Come to me and I will show you how your fellow officers were executed by federal agents on the behest of corporate counsel. And this happens every single day. Now, Rocco, Detective Ergo, or whatever the hell his name is, he maintained a false report. He signed a false report. We witnessed it in real time on March 19th when Oceana County did the same thing. And this detective and this state patrol officer, they signed things that there weren't those witnesses there. They had maintained that there was witnesses. I know without a doubt, absolute evidence that one of the witnesses that they listed was 1,700 miles away. I was on the phone with him at the time. This is what these federal agents do. They establish these claims, and then they provide witnessing. And that's what Sheena was talking about. That's what's coming out in the media now. And you must cover your backs. Because citizens are not your enemy. Your fellow peers that are pretending to be like you are your enemy, as well as attorneys. And now they have the audacity to blow your heads off and call it a murder-suicide, just like they did to us. My sister, Nancy Schaefer, she was a former senator of Georgia. She did a report to Congress regarding the corruption of child protection. And they did the same thing to her. They said her husband shot her in the head, then killed himself because he had cancer. 2 weeks later, they came out and said, no, he didn't have cancer. She was reporting on the House case, which involved not only Plano ISD raping kids, Texas not giving a care, but it went all the way up to Rick Perry, who's traded on down in Bradstreet as a general counsel, and the Department of Health and Human Services, which is the Office of Population Affairs that Henry Kissinger created in 1975 as a depopulation program. Please wake up. Please realize that humanity is the target. Law enforcement officers are normally humans. You go into law enforcement to protect humanity. And you've got these false flags in there, detectives, FBI agents, others trained at Quantico, who are false flagging you and causing this civil war between humanity and law enforcement. We can stop this. You just have to realize what's going on and who's killing who. Who's doing these things? Now read the case. Go to chooseyourside.org and you'll see all about Andrew Siewert. All about this corporate counsel attorney who likes to implicate fourth generation warfare. That's his function. That's what he does. He's a psychopath. Him and his cronies in the black dresses, they're all psychopaths. They are human trafficking. They were found guilty of genocide. We walked all the way through, on record, the genocide of Bo's mother. And then within a month, we evidenced the genocide of Joseph Reynolds, Phil's dad. Now, these things just don't, they're not happenchance. This is what the CIA does. This is what attorneys do. This is their function, genocide. That is what national security is. It is not state security. State security refers to the humanity, public law. National security maintains that it's protecting corporations. The corporation, national, foreign states are defined under 28 U.S.C. subsection 1603. And they're defined also in the Foreign Sovereign Immunities Act itself, which is 28 U.S.C. chapter 97. Another one of my spiels, huh?
any more pieces you want to go over with this case out of Indianapolis here?
I want all of law enforcement and all citizens to read the comments on that story. Family and friends are there. Other law enforcement officers that knew these beautiful souls are explaining their lives and evidencing that they would not do that. He would not do that to his wife, and he didn't.
It's got a long link, but if you go to WTHR.com, maybe search that, WT is in Tom, HR.com, and the headline is, I am PD officer fatally shot by ex-husband in murder, hyphen suicide.
And we know that it wasn't. I mean, other officers have come on, and please keep them safe. Please keep the other officers safe that are coming out, because when they're evidencing that these people wouldn't do that, of course they're whistleblowing and they become a threat to the attorneys.
IMPD must be Indianapolis Municipal Police Department.
It looks like it.
They've got 1,500 employees.
Yeah. And they're all directed by corporate counsel, which is Andrew Seward. I mean, it's just sick because
right. So Andrew Seward has an army of 1,500 down there, and
yeah,
of course up here he used the county sheriff.
Right. And wherever he's at, he's the bank. That's what corporate counsel is. He's a conservator, guardian for the national states. This is what they do. They discharge congressional bankruptcy by using human beings, including law enforcement officers, not agents. If you read the 1929 Geneva Convention, there's no agents in there. There's no attorneys, only citizens and officers. Please realize what's going on, because you are at risk. Our law enforcement are at risk. And our citizens are at risk because they're thinking the law enforcement is horrifying. The law enforcement is the one directing policy. That is not so. Absolutely not so.
Now, there's this guy named Mike Hansen, appears to be a police officer from his little icon picture. Seems to be commenting all over here. Have you read his comments?
No, I haven't checked on it since afternoon.
Your comment reads, now talk about domestic terrorism and how corporate counsel just murdered two police officers to get at their retirements. Andrew Seward there is one of the best at fourth generation warfare, using his detectives to facilitate national security measures stemming from the National Security Act of 1947. This is what this is all about. These productions are all in line with promoting civil war, just as you said, according to the National Security Council and related agenda. See Fourth Generation Warfare and on YouTube. You got a link there. And only one person thumbed you up, of course.
Right.
Got all these fluffy
ones. And the
ones.
Link was to human capital, human trafficking, a special report on human trafficking, because that's what
yeah,
it all
oh, yeah,
is.
Human husbandry, yeah. Wasn't yeah. it?
And human husbandry earlier. But what did that other officer say? Was he speaking about them? Because when I stopped reading this afternoon after I got busy and stuff, it was like everybody was saying that this is not them. They're so beautiful. This can't be happening. Well, it's not happening. This was facilitated by federal agents. They killed two law enforcement officers and blamed each other. And now the attorneys are probating their estate. This is how they raise everybody. This is how they raise humanity.
Well, the reason I think this guy is a cop because he's answering two questions regarding charges. You know, and this one guy is saying to, you know, let's see, if you wish to restrain somebody in the county jail, is much more efficient than a piece of paper. You know, so he's basically saying, you know, why can't you go pick him up, you know, lock him up for some reason, make something up so they can't hurt each other, you know, to keep him safe. And he's coming back with no such charge in Indiana, no terroristic threatening, etc.
Right.
So,
and it's the same thing over and over again. And then you've got the CIA all along there, and they're pitching domestic violence, and they're pitching all of these things. Now, I was a victim of corporate counsel. And we walk all the way through.
And the whole time everybody's telling you, well, you need to get an attorney.
Absolutely. And the whole time I'm being
attorneys are preying on you. And then you know, the courts say, well, you got to get an attorney.
Absolutely. And that's what eventually allowed us to take over the court and form and establish the United States court, because they had condemned their courts. I evidenced start to finish. They did nothing but prey on me. They were not protecting females, children, males. They weren't protecting anybody. But that's what the special drawing rights pay for. That's what the Treasury dollars are for. All of those funds. And not one time. And you can read the case by going to chooseyourside.org and going to the resource section, the authorized documents. The case is in there. And that's what happened. We were, you know, Jesus said, you know, suffer all things, bear all things. Just let them do whatever they're going to do. And we did.
Well, I think that's an important thing that people have to recognize as well, is that we've been recognized by the State Department.
Understood.
Ed Perlmutter and right. Et cetera, et al. Goes up, down and down.
Right.
Biden. And
right. They understood the United States court because... You know,
Speaker of the House we put on there. I can't remember offhand, but
right.
it's that one's on the upload now, isn't it?
Right. Everything's in there, and John Boehner. But we were understood by the United States Incorporated as a court because Andrew Seaver and his cronies evidenced that they were doing nothing but preying on humanity, and they were found guilty of kidnapping, they were found guilty of genocide.
Yeah,
and all of these things.
Nobody could ever get past the work product doctrine and evidence these things, because nobody was getting any evidence on the record by the way that the Star Decesis set everything up under the communistic courts.
Right, 1938.
Yeah.
They allowed attorney work product doctrine. So now instead of, okay, I have evidence that, you know, so-and-so killed so-and-so.
And you must put it in the form of an exhibit.
Right.
According to their court rules.
Right. And law enforcement is experiencing and has been experiencing the same thing. You have evidence that a crime has been committed, and the attorney says, oh, you can't use that because it violates HIPAA. Or you can't use that because it violates her rights or his rights or whatever else. So they sweep it right off the court record. And then they get ringers in there, the expert witnesses, psychiatrists, all of these other ringers. And, of course, the innocent one is always found guilty. And the abuser is always given children, and the abuser is always let out into the community. There's never any accountability unless you are adhering to the public law. Do no harm. Those things do not exist. A judge is bound by judicial canon. A judge can only see evidence, viewing evidence, and ruling accordingly. An attorney practices law. An attorney in a black dress is not a judge. And that's something that everybody needs to wrap their minds around. There's only judicial immunity if that thing is a judge. There haven't been any judges since 1789, 1832 again, 1938. You know.
So we got evidence on the record by using the admission statements.
Right.
And you can't strike an admission statement, even by their own conjured up rules. They had to impeach the evidence.
Well, they had to strike it because of the insurance. And I didn't realize
they did strike it, but they can't.
Right.
That's against the rules to do it, but there they are doing it.
Right, but I found out when we went to their insurance that that's the reason they struck it off the record, because they didn't want the insurance to know that they were perpetrating war crimes.
Mm-hmm.
That's why they strike it, and I didn't realize until we were dealing with the actual insurance, and then all of a sudden it hit us. Well, oh my goodness, that's why they're striking things off the record, because it doesn't go to the insurer. So they're making one claim, a complaint. You know them as complaints, or there's prosecution that the prosecutor brings. Those are insurance claims. So each time that you sign one of those things, they're using you as a witness, but that's not what happened. That's not what occurred. So they're using you, law enforcement, as a fall guy, and we went through that with on leaving the farm on Thursday. You know, talking about these officers and detectives that were signing things that they didn't have any ability to sign. You know, here's detectives, they're screwing kids and trying to get them to be witnesses against other people, and we just witnessed this start to finish on March 19th. I recorded the whole experience, and here we get the 911 report back, and it's all cut up. The whole experience isn't there. And then the police report is contradictory to what I have on recording and what actually occurred. And here's detectives and FBI agents signing it along with the prosecuting attorney, corporate counsel, and the chief banking officer, which is, quote, the judge. Now, these things have to stop here. It's up to us to fix these things. Don't run out to an attorney and ask them what to do, or petition Congress, which is your abuser in the first place, to make up some other law and put money in their pocket. You need to get out of this system immediately and stop patronizing it. And again, just be well. My God, they have this. We're their enemy.
Yeah. So that's how we got the evidence on the record. And of course, they were blowing stuff off. You know, now we can't have that. We can't have the truth make it onto our court record, because these are, you know, places of business. I mean, this court that we're dealing with is set up through the 1789 Judiciary Act. Okay, and that allowed for these courts to be basically places of business and banks and basically it, you know, it sideswipes the sheriff, so the sheriff can never act as a sheriff was intended to be, which is a steward of humanity.
Absolutely, and you can read this in the separation of the spiritual and temporal. And the sheriff was the treasury. The sheriff was the bank. All he did in his county, the sheriff took care of humanity. If something happened, the sheriff would take care of it. There wasn't any banking and human trafficking and attorneys. There wasn't any of that stuff. There was just a sheriff and humanity. The sheriff was elected, of course, by humanity to take care of humanity. And that's where the money goes. That's where everything's supposed to be going. But Congress came in and started undercutting all the sheriffs. And then they put you guys absolutely low class on the totem pole. And here you are, you're the fall guy for them. And what do you get for it? When you're about to retire, they blow your heads off and say that it was you that did it? That's sick. That's absolutely horrifying. That's the same thing they do with citizens every day.
Yeah. Just watching a video here with the sound turned down and reading the story in South Bend, there was a guy that was attacked by a police officer, essentially, because he was near his home, and rather than pull over right there, he decided to finish driving home to his driveway. So as soon as he got out of the car, tased him and beat him and put him in the hospital, and this lady's saying, well, she'll never be able to trust law enforcement again.
And this is in Indiana again?
Yep.
Holy crap. Huh. They just, it's ridiculous. Was that FBI agent that did that?
I just found the link off of I was seeing what was on the Cato Institute. It doesn't look like that story from Thursday made it up here yet. The one we were just talking about in Indianapolis.
Right, because the Cato Institute is run by attorneys. They're not going to put that one up there that's a sad story about law enforcement. They're going to put something up there that's egregious to pit humanity against law enforcement. That's the purpose of the Cato Institute.
Well, we'll see. The time they published their last list here, it was also on Thursday. It doesn't say what time this incident we were discussing happened, 5:30 p.m., Thursday, I believe it said.
Yeah, I don't know if they're going to post it or not, because they have no empathy with that thing. It's full of attorneys.
Watch for it. But, of course, there's a lot of, there's all the police misconduct stories are there. Policemisconduct.net, as we said, make sure you're aware that this was written, Cato Institute.
By the attorneys.
Attorneys. So.
It's the same as the Southern Poverty Law Center that attorneys or that law enforcement have been using up until this year. Now, the Southern Poverty Law Center was outed in federal court as being a domestic terror cell. Now, what does that tell you? When you're told, go to an attorney, you need an attorney. No, they've been outed as domestic terrorists in federal court. Attorneys perpetrate genocide on a day-to-day basis. That's how they make their money. They trick people out, litigate in court. Why is court or the legal process called the adversarial process? Adversary, the word Satan means adversary, the one who plots against you. That's Satan.
Do you remember that? Remember that term we discovered in shipping? We were looking at the names of ship parts because they really do play into the mechanics of this banking that's going on.
Absolutely.
I guess because it stems from maritime admiralty law.
Yeah, admiralty, it's separate from maritime. Maritime is a specific time zone, the means of taking human beings.
Okay. I tend to intertwine those sometimes, but you're exactly right. But the trick was, I believe it was the term used for the time that the steerer was at the wheel.
Right, and I can't remember that word, but I have it. I have that link on my Facebook wall as well, because I've been...
get some headlines while you're doing that.
Yeah.
Just real quick.
Yeah, I should have it up in a minute.
8 vaccinated students at New Jersey College contract mumps.
Oh.
So there's your vaccines giving you the stuff and making you sick with mercury and everything.
Sick.
37% of voters fear the federal government.
Of course. My gosh, they're scary. All they are is a bunch of psychopaths.
Vermont Senate passes mandatory GMO food labeling law.
Vermont and Virginia and all of those, they also had the eugenics program that they started there.
Now, China is not even going to take GMO imports now, so that's gonna kill the farmers that have been growing all this GMO. And
right.
Not that they should be growing that crap anyways.
Right, and then that causes hunger, by the way. Hello, look at what attorneys do. Development grants for Monsanto, they develop something and then cut everybody off. That's the action of supply and demand. They're cutting supply and increasing demand, and then what happens? All of humanity goes hungry thanks to the attorneys. Attorneys kill people. Attorneys litigate. Attorneys do this.
Now, of course, here just going by what I was seeing on YouTube a little while ago on CNN, a Denver plane was... turned back due to an undisclosed threat, and everybody was okay, but FBI was interrogating or interviewing all the passengers.
Of course. Yeah, trying to, that's reconnaissance. They were convincing them of what happened during the time that they experienced something else that the FBI is convincing them happened. That's the whole point of what they do. It's reconnaissance, using psychiatry to convince the victims of some type of war crime that what they saw really didn't occur, and this is how it occurred. And you live this every single day. You see this on the news. You see this everywhere. This is their whole purpose. Cognitive dissonance cannot be created unless you're presented with two truths that are conflicting in the mind. That makes you disassociate. And then you act like children, so you can be programmed easier by these attorneys. Hello, attorneys, attorneys, attorneys. You have to realize what all of these things are. You know what? They censored my wall again. So it was, I've got it in emails.
Yeah, if attorneys are allowed to go on, the internet's just going to get worse and worse.
Oh, it's horrifying because the production keeps, well, now it's like a B-movie production anyway. I mean, it's crap because here they are, they're losing funding. And that's another thing with why they're taking law enforcement. They have to do this because they lost all their funding because they've been found guilty of genocide. So now they're taking law enforcement pensions and all of these things to help alleviate some of that pain that they're dealing with.
South Korea, arrest warrants issued against captain of that sunken ship there in off of coast of Korea.
Yeah, yep. And it was attorneys. Look, they just killed 300 people.
They told the people to remain in their cabins while they were sinking.
Yes,
go back to your cabins.
Can
you believe
that? That's what attorneys do, though. And you people, you need to realize that the UN on these peacekeeping missions is killing people. South Korea and North Korea fax each other. They have contracts with each other because they are the Republic of Korea, by the way. And said, we're at war, hurry up. So they indemnified human beings, and what happened just now? They killed 300 children. Hello? You need to wake up and realize what is going on here. It's like Pink Floyd song, Is There Anybody Out There? It's like beating our heads against a wall. You need to realize that humanity is at risk. Everything is happening to humanity at the behest of these attorneys.
IRS awards contract to surveillance company that tracks license plates.
Yep, there you go. So more fear for you're being surveyed. Hello, but everybody's applying for welfare benefits and applying for retirements and applying for accounts and applying to have their mail posted this or there. And you're giving them all of your information. You're filling out census forms. You're filling out Delphi surveys on a day-to-day basis. Oh my gosh, I won the Publishers Clearinghouse. Let me tell them all about my family. I have four kids and I have, you know, my grandmother lives with me and she's sick and on chemotherapy. And then what happens? Fourth generation. Warfare says, oh, somebody's at the other end and putting that information into the silent weapon, and out pops what? Fourth generation warfare. So you give them your information, they put it in a machine, they know how to attack you now because you just told them what your fears are. You just told them who's sick. You just told them you work 80 hours a week, so they know when to come and attack you. When your kids are home because they're latchkey because you're working 80 hours a week. Stop doing these things. There is no need for surveillance. You do it all yourself.
Yeah, we got all these people that are really not liking, quote unquote, their government. Well, that's because it is your government. I like my government. My government is pretty cool. But, you know, they have adversity towards it, but yet they keep getting all their sign-ups for this and licenses and all that, buying right. Their licenses.
Right, you don't need the NSA because you go down and talk to social workers and you talk to CPS when they call and you talk to whoever and you get attorneys. That is your worst nightmare.
But people are so afraid to give up, you know, all those things that make them comfortable, I guess, like driver's licenses is a big one. You know, bank accounts is another.
This has to stop. That's how genocide is occurring, because you're taking up all these titles. You say you're black, white, red, yellow, brown. You're something special. You're a teacher of this or a doctor of that. Stop taking up any title. Stop registering anything. Enter into your own house. Patronize your own houses and uphold the public law, which means, period, do no harm. Do not harm other human beings.
Mastermind CIA Torture program describes it a success.
Sick. Sick, and that's Diane Feinstein, but they'll point a finger at somebody else. Harry Reid is part of the Senate Intelligence Committee, the Select Committee on Intelligence. Harry Reid, the one presenting the Bundy fiasco, along with Diane Feinstein, like one of the worst psychopathic females ever. Know your enemy.
Yeah, in an interview with The Guardian published on Friday, James Elmore Mitchell has described the CIA's enhanced interrogation program as a success.
Yeah.
And we've seen story after story how all this money, time, and effort has gone to mostly just, well, almost completely, well, let's just say 99.99999% completely just got us nothing. Got us nothing. Because, you know, they want intelligence on Al-Qaeda, which is CIA.
Right.
They're trying to get intelligence on themselves.
Right, but those who just paid taxes for that study, ha, 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 ha.
Yeah.
You just got raised, right? They just did a drive-by raising. So here's Congress, and it says we need to do a study on the CIA, which is Congress. That's Congress's baby. Go read the 1947 National Security Act. And it said we're going to study if it's effective or not. You paid for that. Ha ha. Joke's on you. Egg on your face. Stop being patriotic to this idiotic thing.
Geneva Agreement on Ukraine translated. Let's see here. Geneva resulted in an agreement that is in favor of all that is good and opposed to all that is bad.
Yes. Oh,
what a bunch of fluff that is. Yes. That's the basic gist of it. But what does that mean? Let's translate the memorandum from the language of the high diplomacy into the language of the Ukrainian crisis. Yeah, that goes on there, but my goodness, you're just selling that stuff, aren't they?
Just go read the treaties. Go read their peacekeeping missions, and you'll find out right away that peace, according to Congress, means slaughter. And you can go read this on Google Power Kills. Go read Rummel's site.
Peace means slaughter?
That's what they've been doing. It doesn't mean... We think it means peace, right? It means peace to us. But according to the UN, their actions mean that peace means genocide. That's what all of these peacekeeping missions are. In the Ukraine right now, they have the CIA on the ground perpetrating civil war. In Syria right now, they have the CIA on the ground perpetrating civil war. Now, they tried it in North Korea just a couple weeks ago, and what happened? What happened when Kim Jong-un realized that there was a CIA agent about to perpetrate civil war in his country? He burned him alive, fired him. He knew what was going on. This is how they take over governments. They put CIA on the ground and perpetrate what appears to be a civil war. Now, they have admitted this in the mainstream media. The CIA, the underwear bomber was CIA. The Muslim extremists, California, FBI. The Bundy Ranch, look at all of those actors. Start with Alex Jones. He's human. H-U-M-I-N-T.
Yeah, that was a good expose you did on your show yesterday. I was listening to the first part of the first hour again, and you covered everything from him to Sheriff Mack.
And Harry Reid. Harry Reid is CIA. He's one of the directors of CIA. He's sitting on the Senate Intelligence Committee with Diane Feinstein. I don't know how to hammer that home to the sheeple, because they think that this is a real occurrence and that this is something that's happened. No, it's promoting a civil war between citizens and law enforcement. Read what the media reports that came out of that yesterday. It was sick. Now they painted all these citizens and these patriotards as nothing but terrorists. And what does that get us? It gets those patriotards bullseyes on their foreheads and their backs. And law enforcement will be blamed when one of those patriotards are killed. And law enforcement will be charged and whatever else. And the attorneys run off laughing their asses off again. Look at the original Civil War in America. Congress came in and said slavery is legal. Law enforcement was upholding that law, killing citizens. Citizens were killing law enforcement because that's a freaked up law. And Congress went off laughing all the way to the bank. All the attorneys stuffed their pockets full of all that gold and ran off elsewhere. Nazi Germany, same thing. But they found a new way in there through the action of psychiatry. Now, Ernst Rudin was one of the directors of the CIA, CIG back then, Central Intelligence Group for Germany. It's administrative psychiatrists. The minute Nazi Germany was all over, Ernst Rudin was put in the American administration to finish out his little program. By 1974, we had Dr. Henry Kissinger in there, administrating the same Nazi program. In the Americas. This is Nazi America. Learn your history. Margaret Sanger. Planned Parenthood. That's a eugenics program.
Yeah. And of course, Secretary of State doesn't even have a semblance of being... It doesn't resemble being elected by the people at all.
No, that thing's a clearinghouse.
I mean, if you even believe in that voting garbage to begin with. But.
Right.
Side issue. And perhaps related headline, see the scathing documents detailing $600 billion squandered in Afghanistan.
Absolutely. And where did it go? Now, in the sheeple mind just now, you said in Afghanistan, so this money's just floating around a country. It's not in any attorney's pockets. It didn't go in any attorney's pockets. It's just flowing down their rivers, right? Just laying there on the ground. No attorney's profiting off of that. Congress isn't profiting off of that, right? That's what that story says. It's just laying there somewhere. Nobody's claiming it. What did the attorneys do? They went and perpetrated civil war in Afghanistan. And the patriotards paid for this shit. And they will again and again. Witnessing Nazi Germany. Witnessing Colombia, Pol Pot. Witnessing the Falklands. Malaysia. Malaysia was the first use of Hearts and Minds. The Department of Health and Human Services offering them food and welfare benefits if they'd only align with the politics. And what happened? You reported on that this last summer in 2013. These women are being held in prison states.
Yeah. You know, it's quite sad. I mean, yeah, they got raised and then now woman, yeah, they had her baby. They were letting her see her newborn baby
one hour a day because she was in a prison setting. She was called a refugee.
Yeah, they're helping her that's how they're helping her.
It's absolutely sick because that child ends up with reactive attachment disorder. You know what happens there?
Yeah, psychopaths are breeding more psychopaths.
Yes, and it's horrifying. This is attorneys doing these things. It hurts my heart, and I pray to God every day that law enforcement and citizens alike will hear me. These things are horrifying.
Yeah, yeah. If not, it just goes on and on and gets worse and worse until there's like 400 Fukushimas and, you know, most everybody's dead. You know, Georgia Guidestones, you know, was maybe a high estimate.
And to all law enforcement, it was the Bayer Corporation, Bayer Corporation, that came in to indemnify Poland. They were cutting overhead. That means law enforcement and others on state and federal employ.
That's what we're seeing going on here, the story we read about Indianapolis.
And yes.
Everything else, really, if you look at it, all these cops getting charged and stuff.
Yes.
It's not so many, not seeing so many FBI
and you're not
and seeing as attorneys as you like, but although a few attorneys are starting to, you know, the lower of the totem pole attorneys, especially the ones that have lost their bar license, they're particularly on the hook.
Right, and you're not going to see as many citizens. You're going to see more law enforcement, more teachers, more doctors. You're not going to see as many citizens because they still need to sell to the citizens that this is a good policy. But cutting the overhead the way that they did in Nazi Germany is cutting all law enforcement, state, and federal employees. And Obama said that in his State of the Union address. He said everybody's going to be demoted. You guys are going to be paid $10.10 per hour eventually. And that doesn't mean that you're going to get a check that says you're getting $10.10 per hour. That says you're going to be shot in the head by your husband, quote, and then he's going to shoot himself in the head. And that all evens out because they're going to take all of those assets through probate court, probate that estate forever. His kids aren't going to get anything. Her kids aren't going to get anything. And who walks away laughing is these attorneys cutting overhead and cashing in on taking your estates. That's the bottom line. Now, I don't care if you want to kick and scream or cuss me or whatever you're going to do. Just get it through your head that you are in the war. You can hate me all you want, but as long as you come back and realize that you are in a war, I am not your enemy. Attorneys, attorneys, attorneys are your enemy.
BP manager in charge of cleaning up the Gulf oil spill, instead of actually cleaning up, committed insider trading and sold $1 million of BP stock before the extent of the spill became public knowledge.
Right. On the Beverly Hillbillies, when he shoots his gun and oil starts coming up out of the ground, did he ever ask the American taxpayer to pay for all that lost oil? That's what BP said. They punched a hole in the ground and said they lost a whole bunch of oil and then stuck it to the American taxpayer.
Kill the environment, which is going to have the fallout of killing countless you know, members of the marine beings, and then that trickles down to our food chain. The Corexit 9500 has caused many people health problems down there, and the doctors, they're just going to ignore it and diagnose you with something else and give you some kind of drug.
Right, they're cashing in on it, and you can
see it's killing you.
Right, that's from the 1974. Memorandum 200 from Dr. Henry Kissinger that said depopulation should be the highest priority of all foreign policy. That's the oil spill.
And so instead of sticking up for humanity, here's what they do. Here's another headline. Illinois cops seize computers and cell phones and search for Twitter account mocking mayor. Which we know is Rahm Emanuel.
Yep.
Gestapo leader.
So cops are out enforcing corporate policy in Illinois.
Police in Peoria, Illinois. The Peoria Journal Star reported that authorities executed a search warrant. So, unbelievable.
It's these terroristic threats. Somebody said something bad about a mayor. Now, let's go back to what happened with that hairdresser in North Korea now, because he got a visit from...
Okay, yeah, I did a video on this, so I can recap real quick. Right. London hairdresser puts up a sign in his window that says, bad hair day, ? It's got a picture of Kim Jong-un. Happens to be two blocks down from the embassy for the North Korean embassy members. And a couple of them came and paid him a visit, asked him his name. He said, well, you'll have to get that from my lawyer, you know. And they just expressed the fact that they didn't really appreciate the sign and asked him to take it down. But he said, no, he's not taking it down.
Did they do anything else?
That's essentially it. I mean, story.
Look, this story is from Illinois in a quote, best country in the whole wide world, United States of America, which is a style or chain of congressional actions. And it's worse for this being that went up against Rahm Emanuel than it is in North Korea.
Yeah. I'd have to say. And, you know, like he says, let no crisis go to waste.
Sick.
Yeah, let's see here. So they seized computers and cell phones, attempting to find the person responsible for a satirical Twitter account mocking the town's mayor. Jeez, that's the Gestapo there.
It is, and it's worse.
That's Nazi Germany.
It's worse in Illinois than it is in North Korea, everybody. You need to realize these things.
Yeah, well, Illinois is the Pyongyang project.
Yes.
That's where it's set up.
Yes, Pyongyang, the educational program here. It's a capacity building program. But look at the relative experience. Everybody is experiencing this in real time. You're a witness to this. This is not a joke. It's not something that you can just pass out of your mind, which is what they require. Since the Gelnhausen Charter, it says, you guys have memories like goldfish. You're going to forget about this anyway. Stop forgetting about this anyway and deal with it. You're living in a country that's even worse than Nazi Germany, even worse than North Korea. And you're not realizing that you are inside the war. The United States Incorporated is perpetrating war against you.
So the account was suspended earlier this year, but not before adding a line stating it was satirical in nature. However, it still used the mayor's name, email address, and biography, and posted content related to sexual activity and drugs, including a comparison between artists and Toronto Mayor Rob Ford, who has admitted to using drugs during his time in office. It had around 50 followers and as many posts before being suspended.
Oh, I wish I would have got the evidence off of it, because it looks like they had evidence of drug use and everything else, and now they're being shaken down for whistleblowing.
Yeah, and I want to give them it's punishable by maximum 1 year jail term and $2,500 fine.
It's domestic terrorism.
Three people were taken from the residence to police headquarters for questioning.
Sick.
Oh, yeah, interrogations. Another two residents were brought in from workplaces. So, I mean, they bring them in handcuffs, probably.
Sick.
There's your free speech working for you, you know. How's that? That's how much honor they have to grant you liberties. None.
But it said they posted evidence of crimes being committed?
It just shows you, though, that they're without honors and, completely depraved.
Absolutely.
Let's see. So, well, yeah, okay. Well, one of the residents, 27-year-old Michael Pratt, told Journal Star he was put in an interview room alone for 3 hours before detectives questioned her.
Right.
They brought me in like I was a criminal.
Right, because waterboarding's illegal. So they just tortured her by hoping to wait her out and scaring her for 3 hours?
My goodness, yes. Pratt's boyfriend, 36-year-old Jacob L. Elliott, was arrested and charged with possessing 30 to 500 grams of marijuana. And 30 to 500 grams? What? How do you make that kind of a jump, you know?
It's a fuzzy math.
He's got 30. Yeah, it's the same thing that in the math they used to, you know, show how the trade centers fell.
Fuzzy math. Oh, this is horrifying.
Same math they're using to find that Flight 370.
Right. It's like that over and over again. Whatever the sheep will buy.
But he was not charged in connection with the count, but they sure got him another charge, didn't they?
Yep.
Oh, man. Let's see. A parody means it's fake.
Fortune.
It was even listed as fake, Pratt told the Journal Star. It was a joke Twitter account, and it searched the whole house. The rest appears to have spurred the appearance of another parody account, which has a picture of artists wearing a Hitler-style mustache and mayor artists. Okay, so Emmanuel's not the mayor.
Mayor Peoria. Emmanuel, okay. I think, is Chicago.
Yeah, right. Can you imagine what Emmanuel will do then?
Yeah.
Let's see, geez. Mayor artist and police chief settings guard can suck it in the description. And they had a Hitler-style mustache. It also openly identifies itself as a parody and posted several tweets mocking both artists and the authorities.
Wow.
Do not mock the authority.
No, but they were saying, the attorneys were saying that that was what was happening in Muslim countries. Remember, they were saying somebody posted pictures of Oh gosh, what's his name? The god, and they get all pissy. This is the same thing in America. Holy crap.
There's a couple comments here by not Jim Artis, and it's got his picture there with the Hitler mustache.
Sick.
You're either with us or against us in our fight against global parity. And another one, if a friend or loved one does say something mocking about us, your leaders, by divine right, you must report them to my pet police department.
Sick.
Well, that guy's right. You know, he's got every right to say that.
Absolutely. But
who does that harm? It does not violate the public law to say anything.
Absolutely, but it mocking and using comedy as a tool of conditioning just presents to the sheeple that they should fear the government, never speak out, never do these things, and it's a human conditioning mechanism, and it's so sad that, you know, humanity would buy into it for this long and fear these. It's a criminal enterprise. It's nothing but a criminal enterprise.
3 million customer credit debit cards stolen in Michael's Aaron Brothers breaches.
Yeah.
There's your cybersecurity for you, for all of you that love that convenience of the internet and paying bills online and banking online and stuff.
How's that
working out for everybody?
How many people are going to contract and say, help me, and call up the FBI and say, help me, when it's the FBI and the CIA cracking all of these codes and everything else? And you did a report on this. The FBI and CIA are on the ground. They're the ones that are facilitating these breaches. They're the ones that are doing these things. They're the ones, they admitted to being the ones to putting child porn on people's cell phones and computers.
Mm-hmm.
And sheeple don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear it. They don't want to see it. They don't want to know that it exists.
Well, it's almost too frightening to consider that they have the power to do that and essentially then just come pick you up at any time they want, you know, and make this shit up.
Right, but the sheeple are required to stand up in unison. One voice. Just one voice.
Yeah.
Patronize your own houses and you'll be safer. They can only do this to citizens and officers who are prisoners of war under the 1929 Geneva Convention. In 1933, the United States of America declared bankruptcy. That means that your country does not exist. So as a citizen of the United States of America, which is a style or chain of events, as a citizen, claiming to be a citizen, you are being maintained as a prisoner of war under the 1929 Geneva Convention. Because your government is gone. They're saying that they're saving you. And if you like how you're being taken care of, if you like watching your neighbors being raped, if you like watching law enforcement officers get their heads blown off in order to tax their retirement assets and their estates, then go ahead and keep patronizing this thing. I'm not waiting around for you to do whatever you're going to do. I don't have the time to do that because I'm required to protect the children. Now that means that if you continue patronizing that thing, it can do whatever it wants to you. My function is to protect the children.
Yeah, that's right. So, the question is, how many people are going to continue to follow that flag and the likes of Alex Jones and
they're going to have to get hurt.
Sheriff Mack and
they're going to have
all these other CIA presentations.
They're going to have to experience pain in order for them to realize what their government is, because there's nothing more I can do at this point in time. I only have to go forward, and part of that is setting in motion things that citizens are not going to like.
Beneficiaries aren't going to like it when their benefits are cut off.
Right. And I'm sorry, but there's nothing more I can do. I waited long enough. And I can't wait any longer.
HMRC to sell taxpayers' financial data. So, and that's what they do. They garner all this information on you, and then, you know, it's supposed to be kept in a safe place or whatever. No, they just sell it.
Right.
They just sell it. It's another commodity.
Right.
More commerce.
Don't give them your information. If you don't want people to have your information, don't share your damn information.
Let's see, more delays for controversial NHS data harvesting program as government advisor says scheme was mishandled.
Yeah, and they call them schemes, but nobody's going to hear that part. Nobody's going to hear that part. Sick.
Bank and insurers sending customers policy documents with more words than Macbeth survey finds.
Aww.
Survey finds?
Yeah, survey finds. That's a Delphi survey, by the way. You can go look that word up, too, because it's maintenance of consensus reality, which keeps you nice and comfy warm in the matrix here.
Well, wouldn't it be nice? Not that you even want to really enter into contract with these law firms, because that's what they are. Banks are law firms.
Right.
Run by attorneys, by the way, just to make sure we're clear. And so even if it was a short document, you wouldn't want to enter into it. But they're saying there's more words on the document than Macbeth. Now, I ran a story the other day about pointing out the amount of paper that these environmental hazards known as attorneys use in their court documents. It was that one that Bo Biden was bringing charges against, that Michael something.
Right.
Kenneth. No, let's see, it's not right. But he had a huge stack of paper, and it was probably just part of one case. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Well, Article 14 of the Rules of the Exchequer, it says what the thesaurus is. That thesaurus sometimes means the money itself, sometimes the place where it is kept. No, moreover, that thesaurus sometimes means the money and cash itself, as well as gold or silver vessels of different kinds and changes of vestments. According to that acceptation, it is said, quote, where the treasure is, there will thy heart be also. For thesaurus is called the place in which it reposes. Therefore, thesaurus equals arethesis, namely the place of gold. So the reason that attorneys are using so much paperwork, each word is worth gold. Now, when you go through it and you realize that each page of what your attorney's done for you is worth, what, 80 cents, I think they said? So, you know, it's like...
80 just, or 90 cents a page, I think.
Right, it's just absolutely profound how much information is being stored and what they're cashing in on and what they're claiming in these insurance complaints. So you have to realize, my gosh, every word that is spoken is worth gold. And when you're speaking it in the legal process or within those banks, that's your hypothecated state. Every time you claim something else, I've been injured, that means you've been brought into law. I want my damages. That means that you're claiming that you've been damaged under your chosen patriarch, your chosen father. And so your father there is going to give you an allowance. Now that stipulated allowance is under the debenture participation program. And you're going to get 0.82% of everything that happens to you. 0.82%. Less than 1%. It's not worth it. Sick.
Did you have more of that Exchequer document to read? And you're finding this on Avalon? Yeah, avalon.yale.edu.
Oh, yeah. So that if one asks about someone where he is, it may not incongruously be replied, quote, he is in the thesaurus. That is, in the place where the thesaurus is kept. Cash, money, indeed, or other things mentioned, having once been put in a safe place, are not taken away except that by mandate of the king. And, of course, we talk about the king's bankruptcy. They are sent to him to be distributed for his necessary uses. But there are many things in the repository vaults of the treasury which are carried around, and they are shut up and guarded by the treasurer and the chamberlains. Now go back to the original charters and you'll find the chamberlains, as has been more fully shown above, such are the seal of the king concerning which thou cost ask, the doomsday book, the so-called exactory roll, which some name the writ of farms, likewise the great yearly pipe rolls, the rolls of accounts, a numerous multitude of privileges, counter tallies of receipts and rolls of receipts, and writs of the king concerning outlays of the treasury, and many other things which, when the exchequer is in session, are necessary to its daily uses.
And what's the doomsday book again?
Well, it says that in the Exchequer as well. Article 16. What is the Doomsday Book and for what purpose composed? When that distinguished conqueror of England, a relative by blood of this same prelate, had subdued the utmost limits of the islands to his rule and obtained the minds of the rebels by examples of terrible things, what you're seeing in the media, it's always the House of Gown, he decreed lest a free opportunity of erring should again be given, that the people subject to him should submit to written customs and laws. The English laws, therefore, being laid before him according to their triple distinction, that is, Mercurian law, Dane law, and West Saxon law, some he rejected, others moreover approving, he added to them the transmarine laws of Neustria, which seem most efficacious for protecting the peace of the kingdom. At length, lest anything should seem to be wanting to the sum of his forethought, having taken counsel, he dispatched from his side the most discreet men in circuit throughout the kingdom. By these men, in this way, a diligent description of the whole land was made with regard to his woods, and this is, of course, surveyors. Oh, I lost my place.
So it's very much relevant to what's going on today.
Absolutely. The book is written, the Book of the Dead is always written in description.
Fourth generation warfare is in
right.
there.
A diligent description of the whole land was made with regard to its woods, as well as its pastures and meadows, which is agrarian economics, also its agriculture, and this description by counties, by hundreds, and by hides. The name of the king being marked at the very head, and then in turn the names of the other lords being placed according to the dignity of their standing, which is titles of nobility, that is to say, those who are tenants in chief of the king. Moreover, against the separate names thus arranged in order are placed numbers by each of which below in the course of the book itself. Whatever concerns these persons is more easily found. This is what we talk about divesting yourself of all that possesses you. Drop those names, because those names make up the Doomsday Book. This book is called by the natives Domesday, that is, by metaphor, the Day of Judgment, or just as a sentence of that strict and terrible last trial, cannot possibly be eluded by any art of tergiversation. So then in the kingdom, contention shall arise concerning these things that are not there noted. When the book is appealed to, its sentence cannot be scorned or avoided with impunity. On this account, we have named this book The Hoof of Dooms, not that in it, in a sentence is given concerning any doubtful matters that come up, but that from it, as from a judgment that has been given, it is not allowed in any way to depart. That's what the Domesday Book is. It's not some book sitting on a counter. It's written as your existence dictates, and as you partake of these titles and the concepts from the Tree of Knowledge.
Kind of seems like it's the corporate council operating manual.
It is. That's what it's always been. The rules of the Exchequer.
Oh, that just figures, don't it?
But that's the rules of the Exchequer. They're pretending to be the king, and you humans are all pieces on the chessboard. The Exchequer, of course, is outside checker, Exchequer. And so if you're the pieces on the board, you're the one that's being manipulated by fourth generation warfare, low intensity conflict, and all of these things by corporate counsel. But if you're above the board, then you're the player, and they're on the board, they're in the Doomsday Book. And that is your land, your estate, and this goes all the way back to Forrest and Chase's Charter, Agrarian Economics. You can study this all the way back to Rome. It always happens the same way, and you have to get off of that board. You have to stop patronizing something that you're calling the king, because you are the king. You are God. It's taught you that you're not God, and that's how you're on the board. And of course, when you go to what the Exchequer is in the very beginning of the rules of the Exchequer, the disciple comes forward and says, well, what is the Exchequer? The reason for its name. The disciple says, what is the Exchequer? Master says, the Exchequer is a quadrangular surface about 10 feet in length, 5 in breadth, placed before those who sit around it in the manner of a table, and all around it, it has an edge about the height of one's four fingers. What is that? That's a bench. That's the bank. That's the thing that the attorney in the black dress sits behind and determines your fate while you are being written in the doomsday book, the book of death. Because you're going in there and you're pretending to be dead. You're playing that dead thing by claiming a fictional title. That last name is a description. It has a patent on it. That is not you.
Well, I wanted to get your take on this story here. This may or may not be related here, but in a rare Perry Mason moment in court, wins dismissal for defendant, desk duty for five police officers. Now, this is in a suburban area of Chicago.
Oh, yeah, and I read this one, and I want to stop you there. Now listen carefully, all law enforcement officers, because you've all been victim of this circumstance, and they're coming after you right now. Go ahead, because these law enforcement officers are signing police reports that corporate counsel writes for them, and these five just got nailed for it. But it was corporate counsel who wrote the reports.
Okay, yeah. Okay, a seemingly routine suppression hearing in a suburban Chicago courthouse last month took an unexpected dramatic turn when video from a police car was introduced that disproved the testimony of five police officers. Okay, so kind of just like what you're saying. They had said Joseph Sperling was arrested after hours, officers who pulled him over a traffic stop, smelled marijuana, searched the vehicle, and found nearly a pound in a backpack lying on the back seat of his car. But the Glenview police video showed the search occurred only after Sperling was taken from his car, frisked in handcuffs, reports in the Chicago Tribune. The newspaper dubbed it a Perry Mason moment, rarely seen inside an actual courtroom. Castigating the officers for their outrageous conduct, Cook County Circuit Judge Catherine Haberkin granted a defense motion to suppress the search, which eliminated a basis for his arrest and resulted in a swift dismissal by prosecutors of the felony drug case against the 23-year-old.
Absolutely. Now, all law enforcement, how many reports, police reports, have you signed? That are written by corporate counsel and the board of commissioners. This is exactly what's going on. Those officers are covering the ass of corporate counsel. They were back then. They signed these reports. And you can't tell me that this doesn't exist. I have the evidence in my hand at all times. I don't speak things unless I have the evidence. And again, going back as recently as March 19th, I have the full recording of the whole entire experience. Then I have the cut-up 911 call that wasn't the experience. It was doctored by Board of Commissioners. This is Larry Van Sickle. And it just walks from there. Now, under the public law, I already know who wrote this report. I already went after the corporate counsel, Larry Van Sickle. I'm not touching law enforcement except for the federal agents that actually facilitated the show. But I'm telling you, I can't stop this from happening until you begin to stand up and turn against corporate counsel. I have the evidence from corporate counsel's mouth
that he has. Yeah, that's in the public on YouTube.
Absolutely. We've got all of this evidence. You are all the way protected by the United States court. That is lowercase. But I can't protect you if you're protecting corporate counsel for some odd reason. That's not fair to you. Five officers just got shit canned for the actions of corporate counsel.
All the officers lied on the stand today, said Harbor Corn, who herself is a former prosecutor. And this was at the March 31st hearing. So there is strong evidence it was conspiracy to lie in this case for everyone to come up with the same lie. The officers were later put on desk duty as investigations of their conduct proceed. Tribune says the Glenview arrest of Sperling last June came at the request of Chicago narcotics officers who had Sperling under surveillance. They asked local police to pull him over in a marked car. which occurred when Sperling allegedly failed to use his turn signal. He says he did. Then one of the Chicago officers testified he smelled marijuana as he waited for Sperling to produce his license and registration. Sperling testified he was never asked to do so. The officer, supported by testimony from four other Chicago and Glenview officers, said he ordered Sperling to exit the vehicle and stand by the trunk as he searched it. However, the video shows the search didn't occur until after Sperling was sitting handcuffed in a police car.
Right.
Another discrepancy in testimony concerned the location of the backpack in which the marijuana was located. Police said it was in plain view on the back seat of the car. Sperling said it was under the seat. If not for the video, which Sperling's lawyer, Stephen Goldman, got by issuing a subpoena to the Glenview Police Department and produced in rebuttal at the suppression hearing, Sperling likely would have been convicted and jailed, the attorney told the newspaper.
Right, and it was the attorney that did this.
Now Sperling has filed a federal civil rights suit over the arrest.
Right, it's ridiculous because it's against the attorney. And here the law enforcement officers are losing their jobs and they're getting sued for the actions of corporate counsel. Now that thing on the 19th, they actually gamed it 2 weeks before that and wrote in their complaint what had happened on the 19th. Or what they said happened on the 19th. They put down witnesses that were not there. One of them was 1,700 miles away. Now, this is not funny. I don't want to see law enforcement as Fall Guys. I want to see corporate counsel and Gitmo for what they've done upon humankind.
Yeah, we need law enforcement to come over to our side and adhere to the public law and uphold them. It's a lot easier. It's a lot less paperwork.
And before they're shot,
the pay's going to be better.
Before they're shot in the head and deemed to be a murder-suicide by corporate counsel. Get it through your head so you're in war. Stop signing any document that you get from an attorney before you read it. And know that because they're videotaping you, when you sign that false police report written by corporate counsel, by the prosecuting attorney, or by the judge, that you are already the Fall Guy. They don't have the evidence that corporate counsel wrote that because you're signing it. Stop doing these things. You're allowing yourself to be the Fall Guy for corporate counsel. And they're rolling through your estates left and right.
And that's why they look over your applications and make sure your IQ's not too high when they hire you. I'm sorry to put it that way, but that is what they do, and that's evidence.
Yeah, we don't mean that in a derogatory way. Go back to 2000. The judges ordered that law enforcement has to have a low IQ in order to be manipulated by attorneys.
Not federal agents, though. Federal agents can have, you know.
Yeah, because they cannibalize the little guy. Now, if you don't, go read Matthew 27. Judas in Anglo-Saxon means with law. So Judas gets this bag of silver, which is in a law enforcement's paycheck, to deliver Jesus up to the chief priests and elders, which is corporate counsel and the local national state. The elders have always been the ones with money. Walmart, Sam's Club, BP. And Judas, when you realize what you've been doing, you hand back your paycheck and you say, no, I don't want to be a part of this anymore. And he always, always, always commits political suicide, which is what happened to those IMPD officers. They got shot in the head. Now, Jesus teaches us specifically, do not speak your intent. Do not go to them and hand back your paycheck. Go arrest them so that they cannot politically cannibalize you. Go out and enforce the law so they cannot come against you and blow your head off. Do not speak your intent. Don't tell them you're coming. And if you don't want to hear me at this time, read the congressional report from 1917. Charles Lindbergh went against them. And he stood on the House floor and he says, "You guys are all bad guys." And he's pointing everybody out. They ended up kidnapping his son and killing his son for him because he spoke his intent. Do not speak your intent. If you're going to arrest them, arrest them. Period. Now you have the authority from the United States court to do that. I have authorized that. The judge is authorized. I've certified that. The judge authorized that. If they want to sue somebody, have them sue the United States court. If you evidence a crime, stop it from occurring. There is no more attorney work product doctrine. There is no more running to these attorneys that are preying on everybody. You have to keep yourself safe now. No more speaking your intent. That's how Judas commits political suicide. Because it has been law enforcement that delivers Jesus up. And we know that it's an innocence. We know that you're just being law enforcement. And you think you're doing good. We know these things. We know that you're the good guy. We know who the bad guys are. And I will die for you. Before I let you be harmed any further, but not if you're patronizing that thing. There's nothing I can do if you're still patronizing that thing.
Yeah, and here they are. Okay, speaking about patronizing that thing, that which we're referring to, of course, that'd be Congress, U.S. Inc., United States Inc.,
United Nations.
Yeah, it's all, under the Atlantic Charter, it's basically they're all tied together through the banking aspect here. And yeah, it is global governance by banksters, which are attorneys. Michigan just became the 34th state to vote that a constitutional convention be called.
Oh.
It says, and no one really noticed. Not Congress, not the media, no one. Article 5 of the Constitution allows for the Constitution to be amended two ways, through congressional vote and through state legislature vote. We haven't amended the Constitution in decades, and now that the states have voted to do so, no one noticed.
Article 1.
So what's all this about?
Article 1, it's bullshit. So this is the CIA again. Article 1, Section 9, Clause 3 of the United States Constitution, which was the contract with the Treasury, says no bill of attainder or acts post facto law shall be passed. That means that amendments are non-existent under the Treasury Commission. Everything that was written after that point in time was a means of embezzling from the Treasury perpetrated by Congress itself. And so if you're establishing yourself as a convention, or you're trying to do something with the Constitution or constitutional theory after Article 1, Section 9, Clause 3, you're entering back into that system. You're patronizing Congress. They came in with the Articles of Confederation, Article 12, and pledged and charged you, the United States, of being to discharge their congressional bankruptcy.
So this was put out by Russia Today, that I should note.
Right.
Of course, Russia Today is
corporate media.
Yeah,
maintained by
they like to stir up stuff.
Right. Broadcasting Board of Governors. Go to bbg.gov, click on their about page, and you'll find out that the BBG has full international control of all civil media. All civil media. And since the Smith Modernization Act of 2012 or 2013, 2012, they legalized propaganda. And this is part of
propaganda.
Yeah,
and they started implementing it in 2013, I believe. So, right. So probably for the last year, that's how you got to look at the news, is that they're legal to go ahead and propagandize you.
Right, which is what that story is. And again, go to bbg.gov, click on their about page, read their about page, and then you'll see the links to the Smith Modernization Act, and it's all in there. There's nothing that's not written. It's just you've been consenting. You still consent, even though you know these things, you're still patronizing that thing. And so it's allowed to do whatever it's doing to you.
Yeah, of course they're going to take care of themselves, like GM food's not served in Monsanto cafeteria.
Sick.
they want their employees to be healthy. They can't eat their own products.
Right, I got a message earlier. I haven't verified it yet, but let me see here. It was interesting from Bruce on my Facebook. It was interesting because he says, you know, Tammy, the FDA sends staff and family members to Hanover, Germany for cancer cure, not treatment. They use hydrogen peroxide and ozone cure, but I would expect you to know that. Thanks for all your great info. I didn't know that, and I'll go ahead and do the research and find everything.
But well, and there's another reason for the public laws, because you're going to get real cures in the medical field. I don't think we'd be able to call it the same thing as the industry. The business model is going to have to change to stop all this genocide, for one, but come up with, support doctors and systems that have real, viable cures and solutions to health problems, not some kind of a pill that Big Pharma is giving you kickbacks as a doctor to push people into taking when they don't need them.
Right.
And they're just killing them.
That happened this week with one of my best friends. They're gay, okay? We don't do titles or anything else. Well, they ended up going to the doctor this week. And the doctor, of course, prescribes prednisone, which breaks down the immunity, and erythromycin, which is a chemotherapeutic antibiotic. So here they are, a gay male is going to be diagnosed with HIV because the doctors, through prescription medication, are breaking down his immunity while they're saying that it's a cure or medication. And this is what happens on a day-to-day basis. If you look up what these medications are, they are chemotherapeutic antibiotics, all of them, Bactra, Septra, erythromycin, trimethylsulfate. You can find all of this information, and it's put out by your own government. You need to delve into what they're doing. Lethal injection medications are hydrocodone, the same medications that you're addicted to. Lorazepam, the same medications that you use for anxiety. These things have a function of shutting down your bodily functions, and they're approved by the FDA because the FDA has contracts with the Ethics Commission to use you as a human test subject. Enough is enough. You have to
stop patronizing. That's part of the thing you're being patriotic to when you're being patriotic. So,
yes.
Here's one that kind of ties in. Gay police chief fired. I would much rather have somebody who drank and drank too much taking care of my child than somebody whose lifestyle is questionable around children.
Sick.
About 100 residents of the small Dillon County town showed up for a special meeting of the town council Thursday night, all with one subject on their mind. Crystal Moore's firing from the police chief post by Mayor Earl Bullard.
Sick.
So the mayor, it sounds like, is spearheading this.
Right, and they do. They pit humanity up against itself and call everybody gay and straight and female and male. And then they sell everybody rights, gay rights and straight rights and male rights and female rights. And the attorneys are the ones that are cashing in for promoting a civil war. This is in your face.
Yeah, well, vaccines kill thousands. Big Pharma profits. And this is allowed to go on and on by people's continual patriotism to the Confederacy. folks, which means criminal enterprise. So, you know, that's the grim facts everybody ought to know.
Absolutely.
Well, too bad we don't have that Alice Cooper song queued up. That's a good one. Grim facts. Yeah, speaking of what, we're getting ready to close out here with something, I guess. That kind of covers the Friday edition of the public law. I hope we got everything out there that people need to know, and people will hear this in the aggregate and if they have friends that are with local law enforcement, that would be, the non-federal police, which include your counties, city?
Yeah. Although
city police chiefs are usually FBI, though.
Right, Quantico trained, and we're seeing now an upswing in not only Quantico trained police chiefs and detectives and all this, they're also trained as attorneys. So be very, very, very aware of who your enemy is and who your friends are. And the rule is keep your friends close and your enemies closer. Do not share your information and do not give them an upper hand by letting them know what hurts you the most, because that's what they use against you. And I love you guys, and I want everybody to hear. And I want everybody to be okay. We need to be well as humanity and stop this nonsense.
Yeah. I mean, the way the system is rewarding police officers now, like this whistleblower. Let me get this one last story in here, because this is relevant. Louisville, Kentucky, to pay whistleblower cop $450,000. Let's see. Louisville Metro Government has agreed to pay a former police detective who says he was demoted to patrol officer on the graveyard shift for trying to help an imprisoned woman prove her innocence on a homicide charge.
Yeah, I saw that earlier, but most of the time detectives are FBI, and I think that's
And I just see here he won $450,000.
Right, so he got paid and for doing this, but he's putting on a promotional show, it looks like. And he's really not interested in protecting anybody. He's just interested in the money. So things like that, really watch and take heed, everybody. And like Jesus said, use your own discretion.
Yeah, just one more here. Gosh, I had so many stories. But Landmark Casey's Pirate Bay user hit with 5-year sentence. Now, this is them promoting piracy is one thing, and it's, they're promoting it as being bootlegging movies and stuff. There's no piracy under the public law because it doesn't harm anybody, and the corporations under the General Welfare Clause are supposed to be there for our benefit anyways. But the point of the matter is that, this guy's going to do 5 years for downloading a movie or something like that. And that's not piracy. What piracy is when they have human trafficked you and used you as a negotiable instrument.
Under the action of bail.
Yeah.
Hostage taking in exchange for money. Extortion. That's what actual piracy is.
Yeah.
And
so I want everybody to know what piracy is, I guess, right. Is my point in that story.
Right. 18 U.S.C. Chapter 81. Everybody needs to read that one.
And that's basically the first thing that I came in with on the USDC case.
Right. And that was after all of the fiasco when Andrew Seward came in as a federal state in a local court. And was maintaining as a pirate. And that's what these attorneys are. That's what Congress is. We're still on the high seas, everybody. Congress formulated not only the Articles of Confederation, but that was the annex to the League of Nations covenant. And then, of course, everybody knows about the United Nations. But League is a synonym for Confederacy. And Confederacy, defined in Black's Law Dictionary, is a criminal enterprise. And that's exactly what this is. And law enforcement has been acting as privateers according to national security policy. And that's why we're here. We want to save everybody. And it's not fair that now the privateers are being pirated. And here the pirates are getting away with all of these things. But we'll be back.
So with that, I guess we're going to sail off.
Yeah. Smooth sailing, everybody. Be well.
You get that piracy song? queued up there? Or?
You want Privateers? Or I was going to play I Love America from last night. You were talking about that, and I wanted everybody to
hear. Oh, you didn't play that one yet?
Nope. I don't think so. I might have earlier, but I'm going to play it again. Be well, everybody.
All right,
love you.
Be well.